Simple truth, simple gospel. We've seen thus far in our study the impact of sin and how the gospel reverses everything sin destroyed. We've explored the necessity of Jesus becoming human, the sacrificial atonement of his death, and hope and victory that is provided in his resurrection. We now turn our attention to his continuing work as he ascended back to heaven. Over the next three studies, we'll study three truths from Scripture about Jesus' continued work for us. And we start that study by talking about and diving into Scripture about Jesus as our high priest. Jesus is our high priest. While this term may be familiar, the role and work of the high priest may not be. Basically, the role of the high priest was to be the bridge between God and humans. He represented both parties. In the Old Testament nation of Israel, we have a real-life example of how this worked. It was the high priest that mediated the covenant, provided sacrifice for the people, and connected the people to God. In essence, basically, he kept a foot on both shores, just like a bridge does. The problem was the high priest was just like us, a sinful human being that was subject to the same effect of sin that we are. That is what makes Jesus' high priesthood different. Hebrews 4:14 says this, "Therefore, since we have a great high priest who has ascended into heaven, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold firmly to the faith we profess." You see, Jesus being both God and human has a foot on two shores. As high priest, he bridges the gap and his continuing work is done in heaven where he sits at the right hand of the Father. Hebrews 7:25 tells us that he is able to completely save those who come to him because he lives to intercede. The Hebrew writer goes on to say in verse 15, "For we do not have a high priest who is unable to empathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet he did not sin." You know, it's always encouraging to know we're not alone in our struggles. It's even greater, an even greater comfort to know that we have help of one that was tempted and has gone through what we've gone through, yet without sin. He has overcome, leading the path for us to follow. Finally, in verse 16, he says this, "Let us then approach God's throne of grace with confidence so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help us in our time of need." Because he sits at the right hand of the Father, Jesus provides us access to the Father. As long as he sits at the Father's right hand, we can approach God with confidence and find grace in our time of need. But how can this even happen? Because as high priest, he established a new covenant or a new way of relating to God. Romans 8:1 described the old covenant as one of sin and death. It was totally based on our ability to keep that covenant or relationship perfectly. And when we did not, we died. Jesus, being without sin, fulfilled and canceled that covenant and established a new one. As high priest, he is the literal connection, the literal bridge between humanity and God. It is a connection based on the eternal redemption that he provided. The new covenant also made the indwelling of the Holy Spirit available. And we'll cover that more in our next lesson. But as we wrap this lesson, I want us to consider the implications of the promise of Hebrews 4:14-16 that we just got through going through. Do we view the throne of God as one of grace? Do we approach it with confidence? Do we seek mercy and find help in our time of need as God intended? I've noticed in my own life and the lives of others that we have this spirit of independence and man up mantra. We don't seek help, and when we are desperate enough to seek help, we come sheepishly, almost ashamed to ask because we think, well, we're too weak to make it on our own. You know, that's the beauty of Jesus as our high priest. We aren't expected, nor are we even able to make it on our own. Jesus made a great sacrifice to be our high priest. Let's honor him by approaching Him with confidence and finding from the Father mercy and grace we so desperately need. Simple truth, simple gospel. It's the good news that continually bridges the gap in our relationship with the Father. Embrace that.